In the previous video, we learned about functor composition. In this video, we will look at it in practice. All right, let's imagine we have a variable called data1 with a value of sum of 12. What we want to do is to reach inside this sum and, for example, double the value. First of all, what is the type of this data1? It's option of number. So what we want to do is to reach inside this option and double its number. In the previous videos, we learned in order to do that, we need an instance of a functor for option. So let's import that and let's rename it to option functor. And by the way, I already import a bunch of other stuff that we're going to use throughout this video. All right, const output one. What we want to do, we want to call the map method on option functor. So it's going to get a function and we're going to apply this to data1. What is this x in this lambda function? It's our number, right? So we can go ahead and multiply this by 2. Well, TypeScript is not happy about the type, so let's fix that. I'm gonna explicitly type the x. So now if I try output one, if I save, we get sum of 24 on the right. All right, so far so good. We already knew about all of this. But what I want to show you in this video is, what if we have a little bit more complex data, like for example, sum of not number, but maybe a list of 1, 2, 3. Now the question is, how can we reach inside this structure and double these numbers inside it? How can we do that? Similar to the way that we do with sum of 12. First of all, what is the type of data2? It's option of list of number, right? We already know that in order to get inside sum, we need option functor, right? And we need to get inside this list. So we need the functor instance for a list as well. So let's import that. While we are here, let's extract this lambda function for readability and name this double. So type double is receiving a number and returns a number. So const double of type double, it receives a number and it multiplies it by 2. If I save, no errors. The other thing I want to do is to create some aliases for this method on option functor just for the readability. Let's do that. So map O, it's option functor dot map, and map L is list functor dot map. All right, now we are ready to double the numbers inside our structure option of list. So const output 2. The first thing we want to do is to get inside the option. So we can say option functor dot map, or simply our alias map O. It's gonna receive a lambda function and we're going to apply this to data2. Now, what is the type of x here? We are inside option, so the type is list of number. Let's do that. So I'm going to rename this xs, and this is a list of number. What do we want to return? We want to return a list of number where each number is doubled. How can we reach inside this list? With list functor. So I'm going to call map L, which is listFunctor.map. And we have a lambda function, and we're going to apply this to XS. Now, what is the type of X? Yeah, it's number. And what do we want to do is we want to double it, or simply we have a function for it, right? So double X. Well, TypeScript is not happy about this x, so let's type it explicitly. its number. Let's try this console log output 2. If I save, we get sum of list of 2, 4, and the rest of it is shown as object. So let's fix that. JSON.stringify. If I save, you will see not readable thing. So let's format this null 2. If I save, we now can see sum of 2, 4, and 6. In a future videos, I'm going to show you how can we create a better string representation for these structures in a composable way using showType class and combinators. But this is enough for our purposes right now. Now take a look at this part. Isn't this look familiar? We have a lambda function, a function that receives a number and calls double with it. This is exactly the same as double function itself, isn't it? Double receives a number and double the number. So we can replace this with a double function itself. We already know that this is called point-free form or point-free style. Now take a look at this part. This is the same thing, isn't it? We have a lambda function receiving a list of numbers and call another function with it and returns that value. We can rewrite this in a point-free form. We can cancel the same parameters from both sides. This is much shorter and more readable, isn't it? Now let's take a look at this part. Doesn't this look familiar? The output of mapl function is being passed as an input to mapo function. You guessed this right. This is a function composition of mapo and mapl. So let's rewrite this. We already know about the compose function. So let's add that. Let's add it here and here. And let's get rid of this extra parentheses. So we are composing mapo and mapl, calls double with it, and then apply data 2 with it. And we need to import the compose. But TypeScript is still not happy. It cannot infer the types correctly. And this is another limitation to TypeScript. Fortunately, the fix is easy. If we define a new compose function with these parameters flipped, then TypeScript will successfully infer the types. Let's try this. Let's define a function called compose_r, which receives two functions, f and g, the first one from a to b, the second one from b to c, and finally it returns a function from a to c. Well, this is not TypeScript, so let's fix that. This is a generic function, so a, b, and c are generic types, and we need to name these parameters. Let's implement the compose r function. It first receives two function, then it receives an input, and what it does, it first calls f with that input, and then the output of it will be passed as an input to g. And now let's fix this one. So I'm going to change map o and map l positions, and I'm going to call this one with compose r. And if I save, we get the same thing. It's sum of 2, 4, 6. This is pretty interesting. We could compose our map functions into a new function, seemingly a new map function, that can lift double to a context of option of list. If you still cannot see this, compare output 2 line with output 1. We have a map function, option functor.map, that lifts double to a context of an option and applies data 1 to it. Here we have a new function, a new map function, that can lift double to a context of option of list and apply data2 to it. It seems that we could find a way to compose functors like option and list. And we know functor interface is nothing but a map function. And we could find a way to compose those map functions. So we could find a way to compose functors. Next, let's try to define a functor instance for our structure option of list by reusing the existing functor instances for option and list. Let's first import the functor1 interface definition. Why functor1? Because option and list receives only one type parameter, or in other words, it's of kind type to type. Let's create a little bit of space here. So our option list functor instance looks like this. We have a map function of a value compose R of map L and map O. And let's add the interface to this. So functor1 of option list. We need to add the URI, which is of the same value. And the last thing we need to do is to add option list to our HKT interface in FVTS. And by the way, if this looks new to you, please check out my video on type class in FVTS. So now let's try our option list functor. Const output 3, option list functor.map. We're going to lift double and call data2 with it again. Console log, output 3. If I save, we get sum of const 2, 4. You know what? Let's do this again. JSON stringify null and 2. If I save, we get sum of list 2, 4, 6. And with that, thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.